Clouds are still locked in. The wedge still has a little bit of a grip on the area. Most of the fog has lifted or in the process of getting out of here, but you see we are still locked in. Here's a live look in Blacksburg with our Virginia Tech Skycam. We're going to try to get a few breaks of sunshine before it sets later tonight. If that does not happen, we're going to break free from those clouds a little bit later on. Temperatures, though, are going to climb back to the mid to upper 70s. We were talking this morning on Virginia Today that it was going to take a while for that to happen, that most of the morning and early afternoon will be held in the upper 60s and low 70s. But you see that jump there as we try to get a few breaks in those clouds, getting back up to the mid to upper 70s. We're going to be all over the place in the temperature department. Look at this again, upper 70s today. We'll jump into the low 80s ahead of a cold front tomorrow, and then we're going to sink back into the 60s on Thursday. Upper 70s, low 80s return as we get into the weekend. So again, we're going to be playing this seesaw with the temperature department over the next few days. You see the showers, most of them to our west, at least the heavier rain, a few scattered showers in and around the Highlands and Roanoke Valley. Some heavier rain now through portions of central Indiana. That's where the heavy stuff stays for now, but that is going to change tomorrow. That's coming in this direction. We're going further west into Minnesota, Iowa. You see that heavy rain developing right along a cold front. The opportunity for some heavy rain is going to be there as we get into tomorrow, and that is not good news. As we all know, we've been waterlogged over the past 10 days or so. This is the flash flood threshold now, the amount of rain it will take for areas to start flooding again, and most of the area in that 1 to 2 inch range in terms of rain to come our way along and west of the Blue Ridge. So again, that means if we pick up 1 to 2 inches of rain, we'll likely start to see flash flooding begin again across south side. That is a little bit better, but still not good. It'll take 2 to 3 inches of rain for things to start flooding again. In terms of what is coming in this direction, most of this falling on Wednesday into early Thursday. And you see there along and west of the Blue Ridge, an inch or two, possibly even up to 3 inches of rain. And again, some of this could fall within a couple hour stretches. There's still a lot of moisture in our atmosphere. I'm tracking that here. There's 2 o'clock this afternoon, a few showers with us. We'll keep that with us through the evening, mainly along the western slopes. And I do think we are going to see some breaks in those clouds as we get into tomorrow morning. Here's 6 o'clock, and you see those breaks, maybe some fog again to start. We are dry to start. Here's what happens though, deeper into the afternoon, late in the afternoon, early evening, you see the darker reds and purples and oranges. That is very, very heavy rain. Again, it will be scattered in nature, but where this rain falls, going to be very, very heavy. And again, could lead to that flash flooding potential later tomorrow in the afternoon through Thursday morning. Temperatures today back in the upper 70s. We're going to try to get some blue sky out there. It's going to be hard, but we're going to try. I think some of those skies clear a little bit better as we get into the overnight with those few breaks of clouds coming in our direction. Warmer tomorrow and then cooler again on Thursday. The rain on Thursday not as heavy, but we do not need any more. For the most part, it looks like we're going to be dry getting into the weekend. Just a chance for a few showers mainly south of our area. Pretty good weekend coming away with 70s and 80s.